A U.S. intelligence report says the Afghan capital of Kabul could fall within 90 days amid a strong Taliban offensive. This report has the details.
The Taliban's advance across Afghanistan could isolate the capital Kabul in 30 days and possibly take the city in just 90. That's according to a U.S. defense official on Wednesday, citing U.S. intelligence. As the militants took control of an eighth provincial Afghan capital, Faizabad. It was the latest in a series of rapid gains around the country as US-led foreign forces leave. The European Union believes the Taliban now controls 65% of the country. The US official said the fall of Kabul wasn't a foregone conclusion, and the Afghan security forces could reverse the momentum by putting up more resistance. All gateways to Kabul, which lies in a valley surrounded by mountains, were choked with civilians entering the city and fleeing violence elsewhere, a Western security source in the city told Reuters. And that made it hard to tell where the Taliban fighters were also getting through. The fear is of suicide bombers entering Kabul's diplomatic quarters, the official said. Faizabad's fall came as President Ashraf Ghani flew to Mazar-e-Sharif, the biggest city of the north, to rally old warlords to its defence as the Taliban closed in. The Taliban are battling to defeat the US-backed government and reimpose strict Islamic law. The speed of their advance has shocked the government and its allies. A commitment to talk peace with the government side has so far come to nothing, as the militants eye military victory.
Allahu Akbar! Allahu Akbar!
US President Joe Biden said on Tuesday he did not regret his decision to withdraw and urged Afghan leaders to fight for their homeland. The United States was providing significant air support, food, equipment and salaries to Afghan forces, he said.
The Biden administration urges OPEC and its allies to boost oil output to tame rising gasoline prices. The White House criticizes big drilling nations, including Saudi Arabia, for what it described as insufficient crude production levels during the pandemic. It says high crude prices will threaten the global recovery from COVID-19. OPEC and its allies had implemented a record output cut of 10 million barrels per day, or about 10% of world demand, as global energy demand slumped at the start of the health crisis. But it has gradually raised output and agreed to boost supply by 400,000 barrels per day starting in August. OPEC will hold a meeting next month to review the situation. Hackers behind one of the biggest cryptocurrency heists have returned more than a third of the $613 million worth of digital coins they stole. The cybercriminals exploited a vulnerability in Poly Network, a platform that looks to connect different blockchains. But in a strange turn of events, they returned some of the stolen digital assets. A person claiming to have perpetrated the hack said they only did it for fun and to expose a vulnerability before others could exploit it. The Poly Network attack comes as losses from hacks and fraud related to decentralized finance hit an all-time high. Decentralized finance platforms allow parties to conduct transactions, usually in cryptocurrency, without gatekeepers, such as banks or exchanges. This boomed over the last year, with platforms now handling more than $80 billion worth of digital coins.